How did you find out about Bitcoin?
My buddy paid me back for a beer with one of those little gold coins that you see, like, you know, like cassatious coins, the, you know, in the news articles, those little gold coins.
Yes.
It was one of those. And so this was back in like 2012. So Bitcoin is like $10.
I'm so jealous. God, how heavy is this, Dan?
There you go, you almost got it. I think it's as tall as you are. Hold on.
Almost.
What's up, guys?
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hey, look who's here.
You shooting some guns?
Okay, wait, tell me what I need to know. I've never done this before.
So, we'll take you step by step. First thing we need to do before we go in there, we gotta protect our ears and our eyes.
So, I first discovered, you know, Bitcoin, NFTs, all that stuff on Clubhouse. And I for sure thought it was a fad. I thought possibly a scam. I saw my friends moving to Twitter Spaces and they were still going. And these are people that they wouldn't just stick around for no reason. And so I got involved. And you know, I started becoming a part of the community, and I'm like, how do I enter this space authentically without being pretentious? And my background is an interviewer. So I'm like, let me just go in, I'll be the interviewer, I'll ask the dumb questions, and it'll help people who are entering the space because I'm not afraid to ask the dumb question.
So really, I'm just going to load this thing up for you.
Cool.
You know how to hold a rifle.
Yep.
You're right-handed?
Yeah, and I've got an AR, so.
Okay, yeah, perfect. Yeah, it really doesn't move all that much. I may not even put my hand on your shoulder if you don't need it.
Cool.
So, yeah, cool. Other than that, let's hop in there.
All righty. We're shooting the German MP40, a German submachine gun from World War II. It's a vintage item.
Side of you I've not seen before. I did not imagine this from a teddy bear.
This is the Texan side of me.
Shocked, yeah. Alarmed,
yeah.
Appalled.
Yeah. My normal life is in Austin here. Austin's got a pretty great standard of living, so yeah, I feel super comfortable. I feel like I've hit those goals when I was younger and wanted to go achieve.
That bad.
No,
I think with money, there's always more, you know, and so that's always, I think, like a humbling process of thinking through, am I happy with what I have? And so, yeah, I'm very happy with what I have. I say a very large percentage of my identity is associated with crypto. I've been in the space 10 years, and so this is something that I believe is important for humanity, and that's my life's mission.
Actually, you mailed this to your ex-boyfriend.
Anonymously, though.
Yeah, exactly.
Anonymously.
All right, ready to go?
Ready to go.
Cool.
Let's go. Hey.
Thanks for having us, Ryan.
Yeah.
We've seen Nicole, but she got distracted.
Yeah, that's terrible. What's up, Nicole?
Oh, hey, sorry. Nice to meet you.
It's Gunner.
All right, so. This is my friend Nicole from LA. She's got to get all Texas'd out. So I took her shooting guns. We're going to go get some tacos. But we need to get her some cowboy hats and cowboy boot. And this is the place to get her a cowboy hat. So,
well, brother.
What do you recommend for her? Right? What do you think's good?
Typically, I'll say, you know, let's look at your color profile, the shape of your face, your shoulder width. That helps determine, you know, brim length, crown shape. Also, just things that generally complement your image. Have you ever played with color?
How much is the other one, by the way?
It'd be
$1,350.
$1,300? Oh, that's it? Dan can afford that.
Yeah.
Let's see, how much Bitcoin is that? That's point one Bitcoin. No, that's point 0.03 Bitcoin.
And ETH is actually dropping right now, so it's almost one ETH.
It's almost one ETH, yeah. In your Ethereum world, my Bitcoin world.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which is interesting to think of it that way. It's much easier to spend one ETH than it is to spend $1,350, by the way. It's a super weird thing in our world. It's easier to spend ETH.
Like on an NFT, you'd go buy an NFT for $20,000, but
I've bought an NFT for $20,000, but if you asked me to spend $20,000 on almost anything, I'd be like, that's too much.
What's the most expensive NFT you've bought?
I bought a goblin for about $20,000 recently. What's the part that takes the longest?
Design.
Okay.
Yeah. Depending on, sometimes it's like ideation versus just, slapping things on.
Yeah.
It's like my brand name's Trovador, Spanish for troubadour, singer, songwriter, storyteller. I want your hat to tell a story about your life. So I ask everyone to fill out this profile looking for overarching themes of your life, significant numbers, travel stories, quote song lyrics, and we build all that into the hat through symbolism. So everything on there is an extension of you. It's all intentional.
I had no idea that it was like that you did that. Does everyone do that, or is that just your thing?
That's my thing.
In the world of NFTs, I love that artists can monetize their work to the extent, that they can make a living off of it and even like get rich the way they couldn't before. I know a ton of artists that are able to like put their kids through school now and do things that they didn't even dream that they'd be able to do because of NFTs. And so that's been really cool. But also when I got into crypto, I learned a lot about financial literacy and I'm still learning. Those hats are amazing. Like they're beautiful, like a statement piece, but to come and actually like sit down and think about like lyrics and themes.
Why'd you say it's like proof of work? No, Bitcoin's proof of work.
Dan, how the dad joke that?
I immediately just have three children. That's cool. Thanks for having us.
Oh, you're welcome. Welcome.
It's my favorite food store. Really wanted to get Nicole all Texaned out. So we're doing, we looked at cowboy hats earlier. Now we need some cowboy boots.
Okay.
Learning more about Bitcoin and understanding where we are currently helps drive that conviction long term. So yeah, it's through learning more about Bitcoin where I felt like I had a better understanding of it. And through that, I felt a stronger conviction.
Being in the spotlight in this field aligns you with some of the smartest people out there in the world and some of the dumbest. It's cool, it's interesting. Sometimes I'm a little worried about like things that I do or things that I say.
It's scary being on that. We're on the edge of like glory and destruction because you can be canceled for something you say, or you can have like Elon Musk retweet you or something.
So how much is a boot like this?
So the boot right there is $590. That's our base price. We go up to $2,000. And that depends on if you get fancy, if you get exotic skins, all different things.
So this
like
one is $590.
Yeah.
Okay,
that's
cool.
Our base price.
All right, Nicole, which boot are you going to choose? You've got your brown ones and you've got the black one. What's the hesitation?
I like the length here.
Okay.
I like the design here. But it's like, I already wear so much black.
Gotcha.
That maybe I should just go with the brown.
The brown is nice because the brown has like a suede look to it, which is a little bit softer. So, yeah, it does look really
good. Are you telling me I need to be softer? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, you're kind of intense. You're like really toxic on Twitter sometimes.
How? So, yeah. How?
Just
I'm so nice to the
shoving your NFTs in her face all the time. Hey, come on, just relax.
Well, how are you about Bitcoin?
Okay, maybe I get a little bit intense too.
How about we both soften?
I think the world's telling us that the brown is what we
need.
Right.
Okay, all right, let's do it.
Awesome, well, let's get you set up.
Decision made.
Cool.
Wow, so they look great.
Thank
you. I'm excited for you. So
thank you.
It's your choice. Do you want to wear them out or do you want us to box them up?
Let's box them up.
Yeah. So I'm going to take care of your payment right here.
Sweet. Okay, cool. But I have to ask, can we pay in Bitcoin?
Sadly, no. But okay. Because you walked in and mentioned it, we'd never thought of it before, but now I'm intrigued.
Okay, cool.
So I'm going to give you my business card and hope that the two of you get in touch with me so I can learn more.
That sounds good. But well, okay. I guess we'll have to pay with dirty American dollars for now.
Fiat? Yeah,
fiat.
Gross. Oh, fiat man. Currency. No.
You know, I used to think fiat, when I first heard it, I'm like, Are they talking about the car company?
Oh,
like,
and it's a bad car.
Did you see the fiat Twitter account? Or they were like, why does everyone hate us so much?
I saw that.
Because of fiat. That's
I love that. Oh, man. Yeah, I saw that.
I feel like it's very empowering to be able to think about these new structures where we don't have that centralized control. You know, that's ultimately why we're here.
Yeah, and I feel like Bitcoin really is truly the only fully decentralized currency.
The way I phrase it is that the other ones trade off decentralization to do more cool, fun stuff.
Yeah.
You know, it's kind of the
And that's cool too.
And that's cool.
You know?
Because Bitcoiners could be, and this is, I think, like, this is where a lot of Bitcoiners don't question the nature of Bitcoin. What if Bitcoin has over-optimized for security or decentralization? It could be over-optimizing for that. I admit that could be a flaw in our thinking in the Bitcoin community, or maybe them trading this off is okay. But I do think Bitcoiners are right long-term. If states attack crypto, you want to be as strong as possible or decentralized as possible. But they could be wrong. They could, maybe states never do attack crypto and you could trade off a lot of decentralization, but we won't know until that happens.
So. Yeah, I mean, where we're gonna be in 5, 10 years.
Who knows?
Who knows?